waste any tape on me because I don't talk much.
Well, you always used to tell us stories. Now you don't want to tell them anymore? I grew up in the suburbs of Connecticut. A lot of people I knew came from a big house, two-car garage, and stocks and bonds. My family was different because my father came from Poland. He immigrated here after World War II. Growing up, he would sometimes tell us the stories of his life.
In 1700, they divide Poland into three countries. Russia took the most. Just when the United States been born, Poland was buried in a grave.
When I was growing up in this town in the 70s, Polish jokes were really popular.
It wasn't a joke to get freedom from Russia, and Russia is kaput. It was a miracle that solidarity knocked down the communist Russia.
Dad, tell me about where you grew up in Poland. You were near Krakow, right? Tell me what your village was like.
Będzieszyna, about 40 miles from Krakow. There was only a few houses there in that village. I was 2.5 years old when my mother died. She died May 4, 1927. She died after misfortune after birth, the triplets. She died 10 days after birth. From triplets, my sister lived, and she died recently too.
Wow, so your sister died in 1993 without you ever having seen her again. Dad, can you tell me about some of your Polish traditions? Like, what did you guys do for Christmas?
At Christmas Eve, one child was looking for the fourth star in the sky. Then they lighted the tree. We used to have candles, real candles, not electric candles. So we had to be careful so the tree wouldn't catch fire. Once the Christmas tree caught fire, but we extinguished it. The father took the holy bread and broke it with mother, and all the family's members broke in bread.
Dad, can you tell me about Germany?
I was about 17 years old when I was taken to Germany.
You didn't have any choice?
I had no choice because if I didn't go, then they would take my father. And my father walked me by the town, was a stream and a little bridge over the stream. Walked me way up over there. And my stepmother made a bread for the road. She baked a bread and I was carrying that bread with me.
Is that the last time you saw your parents?
Yeah. My father was supposed to send me to some trade school, but then the war started, and I didn't go. And the war was 5.5 years, and all those years where I should learn something, I wasted.
Now, your sister was also taken by the Germans. What happened to her?
Yeah, my sister didn't show up for the date, so the police came 4 o'clock in the morning and took her from the bed. And ship her to Germany. They just grabbed her and told her to get dressed and get to the Germany. We used to wear in Germany letter P, that they would recognize us as Poles.
So what were you in? Was it forced labor?
Forced labor, yeah.
How long were you involved in that?
Since September 1942 till April 1945. But I was lucky going to Germany. We went to the sugar factory. So even there was not enough bread, we could eat the sugar. I used to put sugar to soup, sugar to coffee, eat as much sugar as I could. From sugar factory, they transferred us to Hanover, to battery factory for 6 months. Well, it was pretty hard work there. Yeah, we lived through lots of many bombardments. The Americans been running the series of bombardments in Germany. And we go to shelter, and we even didn't have a proper shelter. But we went there underground.
Did you think you were gonna die?
Yeah, I was expecting to die anytime. At night, the airplanes been going pretty low, so the earth been shaking and house was shaking. And those bullets been whistling. like a terrible sound. They've been shooting, the motors been screaming, going down to the ground. And there was an explosion and that's it. Nothing but peace has been coming from the sky. We just been sitting like a mouse under the broom, waiting whether they're gonna dump some bombs or not, but they pass over.
How did you deal with the bombings?
During the bombardments, I had the cross. Yeah, I used to have it in a pocket on my jacket. And I was praying, well, God save me from death. There were so many million people killed and I survived. Thanks be to God. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, amen. Yeah, I believe in second coming of Christ. Christ will come to judge the living and the dead.
So how long did you have to work in Germany for?
I worked until the United States came over and freed me. United States Army entered the Germany and freed the people.
What was that day like?
Yeah, by the April 8, 1945, and the airplanes been diving and bombing the Germans' positions, one after other, one in a circle. Then we seen the troops driving. When the convoy approached closer to the village, we ran to Americans, but because we couldn't talk English, I showed them the letter P on my chest, that I am a Polish. They understood because they knew that Polish, they are in the camps. And then all of a sudden, the Germans starts to shooting and the explosions been all over. And I was running from one cement wall to by the gate to other cement wall and I got shot in a leg. And I was 5 months in the hospital. It was a pretty heavy wound.
Did you almost lose your leg?
Yeah, I got a good doctor that he didn't cut the leg off. A German, the Stab Arts, that's a staff sergeant. My story are small stories, but the real story was just 6 million Jews been killed.
How did you reestablish contact with your family?
I was writing letters, and I told my father that I am going to America. He said, all right.
What was it like coming to America? How did you get here?
The ship took off from Bremerhaven to America, and that's the last time I saw Europe. I landed in New York Harbor, July 17, 1949.
What did you think about this place when you first got here?
I like it. I like everything. It was amazing that America is so built up. New York, I haven't seen big buildings like that in Europe. Of course, I wasn't in very many places.
So you didn't want to go back to Poland, even though your family was there?
Right. There was poverty and communist rule. Many people from Poland, they go to America if they could.
Can you describe what it was like when you met Ma?
Yeah, I met her at Polish home. I went downstairs and I asked Ma to dance with me and we danced. And so we went downstairs to sit down and had to have a drink. And I told her that she has such a nice, a real American look. And she liked that. I thank God that I came to United States and find a work and get married and bought a house and had family. Nice family I have, thank be to God. Okay, Marisha, that's all. Okay, you can shut it off. I'm gonna sing another song. Gdyśmy Chrystus rodzi i na świat przychodzi. Ciemna noc w jasnościach promienistej brodzi. Aniołowie się radują, pod niebiosy wyśpiewują. Gloria, gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo.